Thanks, Bill. Dear friends, here is a 57-year-old female having bilateral osteoarthritis of the knee, and the right side high tibial osteotomy has been done many years back. Converted to a total knee replacement, the alignment looks good, cementing is adequate. These are the post-operative x-rays. 7 years down the lane, there was a osteolysis and a loosening of the components with a fracture of the medial condyle there. And that was the kind of instability which you see on the table, along with synovitis and a bogey knee, which was revised and converted to a, you know, hinge type of knee. And that was a 2 years follow-up of the patient. And that is the function of the patient, a stable knee, well aligned, and that is a function of about 110 to 120 degrees of flexion with active extension. Hence, dear friends, you know, osteolysis is the major cause of aseptic loosening, but this is not the only cause of aseptic loosening, but all the other causes also can lead to loosening. But, you know, osteolysis remains a major cause, including, you know, infection may be another cause of loosening in this kind of cases. Now, osteolysis has been defined as the bone resorption caused by body's response to particular debris generated as the implant wears out. And these debris can be cement particle, maybe metal particles or polyethylene particle, and all of them show different kinds of reactions. But most of them is due to the polyethylene particle. And this polyethylene particle is generated because of undersurface wear in case of modular components. As you can see here, the particle which is generated between the metal and polyethylene is much smaller in size, and hence they give rise to osteolysis. So that's why it is rarely seen in monoblock implants like all polytibia or a monoblock metal back tibia. So what happens? The debris which is produced because of particular debris, especially in total knee due to delaminating wear, the small particles, they get engulfed by the macrophages. And these macrophages, they release all these mediators of the inflammation and the immune reaction. And in the second stage, bone loss occurs due to release of TNF-alpha, RANKL, interleukin-6, and interleukin-1. And they... these mediators of inflammation, they go and they settle down on the bone and they cause osteolysis there. And this osteolysis usually progressive and initially it becomes asymptomatic. But in the stage 3, when the implant loosening occurs, then the patient gets the start of pain. That is pain while getting up from a prolonged sitting, and then gradually it subsides. And subsequently when the loosening becomes more, then patient is painful all the time. And it is especially more common in the tibial component, as you can see here, because of the, you know, stem in the tibia, all the screws, these particles, they trickle down inferiorly and they form an osteolysis there. And that's why the effective joint space is increased here, and hence it causes more loosening and osteolysis. How to diagnose it? Plain x-ray, you know, weight bearing epilateral and skyline view can be taken. But until about 20 to 30% bone is destroyed, the x-ray will not show you the osteolysis. But the diagnostic criteria of loosening and osteolysis is that the progressive radiolucency and implant migration. You can see the radiolucent lines which are progressing more than 2 years after the surgery. Or is there any new radiolucent lines over 1 millimeter? Then you suspect probably there is osteolysis and loosening happening. There may be focal areas of high cortical density, radiopaque lines which you will see, or there may be migration or subsidence of the implant which indicates there is loosening. As you can see here in a cemented implant, the loosening usually seen at the metal-cement interface. That is extremely important. In case of cementless implants, you will see uniform area of radiolucent lines more than 2 millimeter in all the zones. Here is a 57-year-old female. This is 5 years follow-up of this patient after a revision because of radiolucency and loosening, and that is a function of about 110 to 120 degrees because of implant-cement interface loosening. CT scan, if you are not able to see the osteolysis, or if you are seeing the osteolysis, CT scan will show you the increased area of lucency there, or you can do a Mars MRI to know the early osteolysis which is seen in Mars MRIs. How to prevent post-traumatic arthritis, rheumatoid, neuropathic arthropathy, they lead to more of osteolysis because of attenuation of collateral and posterior cruciate ligaments. Hence, you need to use more constant implants like PS or more constant implants. Look out for ligamentous laxity intraoperatively, especially in PS implants, like hyperextension. that may lead to impingement of the polyethylene and cause osteolysis. Avoid excessive flexion of the femoral component or increase posterior slope of the TBR. That may lead to more osteolysis and loosening. The treatment, if it's asymptomatic osteolysis, you can observe the patients carefully over a period of time. You can treat with bisphosphonates. This year, recent literature in 2018 shows that bisphosphonate improves the bone marrow density in total knee replacement, especially around the tibial component. If there is a bogey synovitis and joint effusion, you can do impaction bone grafting and polyethylene exchange. And this is 2018 Will Maloney literature shows this. If there's a start of pain with the patient, then you have to evaluate and assess this patient case-to-case basis. And if the patient is really symptomatic, then you can go for revision surgery. If there is severe pain, effusion, crepitus, and grinding of the knees, then obviously it requires a revision surgery. But always remember infection in your mind. This is a 50-year-old female, boggy swelling. There is little varus replacement of the tibia. Hence, the tibial component was changed with a thicker polyethylene. And this is a 3 years follow-up of the patient with the restoration of the function. Whereas if there is loosening like this, both femoral and tibial component, that has to be revised completely. And you can achieve the alignment and restoration of the alignment of the component. So take-home message, osteolysis leads to loosening. Identify early osteolysis by doing radiological investigations by CT scan or mass MRI. You need to have a regular follow-up in asymptomatic osteolysis. Give bisphosphonates to these patients. Early impaction bone grafting plus polyethylene exchange may prevent a revision in case of boggy swelling, which are asymptomatic. Symptomatic patients with loose implant requires a revision total knee replacement, and this is a growing concern nowadays in total knee replacement. I thank you for your patience.